Doon na tayo kauban karong buntag may gala. Who will help us understand sa pipila ka mga development karon o sa mga dagkong isgutanan ang kalabutan sa kampanya kontra smuggling mga bahay. I'd like to welcome to the show usa siya ka presidente sa Bienvenido Oplas Junior Research Consultancy Services. Presidente po siya sa Minimal Government Thinkers Think Tank. He is an economist, he is a journalist, and he is a research consultant. Si Sir Bienvenido Oplas Jr. Sir Bien, maayong buntag, sir. Magandang umaga.
Maayong buntag, Jun.
Good morning, sir. Welcome sa Straight to the Point.
Good morning.
Sige, sir. Una-una ko, sir. If you may help us, sir, please give us a context. Kumusta man, sir, ang atong kampanya on fighting illicit or illegal tobacco, sir? Ang konteksto, how prevalent is this particular kind of kaning trade, sir?
It's a big problem dun, no? Kaya ang estimate ana sa volume of smuggling at issue of tobacco alone, ang estimate ni Congressman Joey Salceda, 30 billion pesos of taxes is lost every year.
30 billion, sir?
30 billion, oo. Ang kay estimate naman ni Congressman Coco Nograles di Kandiyas sa Davao, 31 to 60 billion pesos a year. Ang taxes sa gan. Ang kay maski mismo si BIR Commissioner Lumagi, ang estimate, up to 100 billion pesos a year. Mga nakadako kayo.
Hala.
So, ibinanin mo ka ng Department of Labor, total budget, 20 billion a year lang na. Maski Department of Trade and Industry, the whole budget is about 20 to 25 billion pesos a year. Now, we are losing 30 to 50 billion pesos a year in revenues. Manadako ang problema.
Yes, sir. So, in gist, sir, unsay epekto ani, sir, sa atong mga programa sa gobyerno which would require big amount of funding, sir?
Bitaw. Okay, halimbawa halimbawa ang estimate na lang karon, no, mga 50 billion a year, even if we can just reduce it to by 50%, no. Uh-huh. Butang ni mga 50, we can collect another 55 billion pesos. Mm-hmm. Kaya ba ka unsay mabuhat ang 55 billion pesos? Mm-hmm. It can fund 7.6 million CCT households, 7.6 million families.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay, ipatindog din mo ka ng mga dagang classroom, you're talking about tens of thousands of new classrooms every year.
Mm-hmm.
Nya, og i-subsidize nimo ang kuryente, mga 23 centavos per kilowatt hour ang subsidized nationwide, gikan mula sulong hanggang mula apar hanggang tawi-tawi na subsidy ana sang kwad. Og mugamit ng nimo, makulit na natong 25 billion pesos of additional revenue from smuggling.
So prevalent yun yung smuggling, sir, ilabi na sa tobacco, sir? How prevalent is it?
Ang estimate na nationwide ang mga up to 20% of total supply smuggled. Paano, there are two types of smuggle, two to three types, no. The most prevalent is yung halimbawa Pariana kanang Maite, Mibius, Marlboro, etc. Pareho yang itsura, pero ang iyang ang stamp is peke. It's not paying any taxes. The other is yung tinatawag na illicit white. These are legal product from, say, Indonesia, Malaysia, Vietnam, China, etc. Pero dili registered din. Makita man din mo kay Lyman Mangalan, na UI graphic signal. So because they are unregistered, they are illegal. So kung mo, ang tax alone this year is 60 pesos per pack. So ang cheapest legal tobacco should be at least 120 pesos per pack. Kunya, bilgyan niya, 40 pesos per pack lang. Niya, illegal na kayo na.
Oh, yes, sir. Sir, with your indulgence, with your permission, sir, mubrek kong makadiyot, sir, ha? And then we'll return, sir, with more questions, sir. Salamat kayo, sir. Standby lang, sir.
Okay.
Straight to the point.
Give me a minute, sir, ha? It's 7:43. Okay, good morning, Kang Del De Los Porlares. Naggalanog-lanog daw ta sa Matiyaw, Davao Oriental. Padayaw ninyo dihang tanan. Kauban gyapon nato si Sir Bienvenido Oplas. Usa kini siya ka journalist, economist megala og consultant, no? Expert ni siya megala sa kaning ekonomiya. Sir Bien, balik ta, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Oh, Arisel, mangutan ako, a while back you said kining mga revenue losses magamit unta nato sa mga priority sa gobyerno. What steps should be taken, sir, to arrest illicit tobacco?
There are three measures that can be done, no? One is the executive branch, the second is by the legislative branch, and the third is the public. On the executive branch, importante yun nga kanan mga lead enforcement agencies like PNP, Coast Guard, BIR, Bureau of Coast Guard should do their job. Para kanang PNP, ilang budget? 192 billion pesos for 2023. Yeah, ang kanang 192 billion pesos, di ka man taxes. Yeah, dili ni mo gan, yeah, dili ni mo trabaho ilang dapat trabaho mo decline ang revenues niya. Ma-depend mo sila sa taxes. Ang Coast Guard 21 billion pesos ang iyang budget for 2023. Yeah, dili sa matabang ana to reduce smuggling, that reduce tax revenue. Dili sa makatabang sa gobyerno. So, importante sa executive branch to enforce the law against smuggling. The second is for the legislative. Kaya ang kung nang ginagawa ka ng problema na anang tax hike, very high tax rate bitaw. Kaya for instance, na in 2021, ang collection sa government was 176 billion pesos from tobacco taxes alone. The tax in 2021 was 50 pesos per pack. In 2022, naging 55 pesos per pack, ang revenue sa government declined to 160 billion pesos. So, naging decline by minus 176 to 160, negative 16 billion pesos for the first time that tax revenue from tobacco has declined ever. So, karon 60 pesos per pack na. So, we're expecting that the revenue might even flatline or might even decline. Tungkol kay ang difference between legal tobacco and illicit tobacco, taas man kaayo. So, there would be need for Congress to revisit the tax rate on tobacco.
Okay,
and third, kanang publiko. Yeah, kay kanang, halimbawa, mabay kag 40 pesos per pack sa illegal, dili mo na, zero mo na wato sa gobyerno. Wato na sa mga criminal syndicate, smugglers, terrorist group, kana magbomba-bomba na dyan sa Mindanao, funded by smuggling o tobacco na sila, na sila kwarta. Plus the corrupt people in government. Mo na nga, og mabayad ka, sige, one pack a day, 40 pesos per day. 40 pesos yung contributing to the smuggler, the terrorist, the criminal group, as well as the corrupt in government. Okay. Dili mayo.
Okay, sir. Salamat kayo. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.
Salamat, sir. Kauban nato si Sir Bienvenido Oplas Jr. Siya mahigala ang presidente sa usa ka organisasyon o research sa consultancy company nga Bienvenido Oplas Junior Research Consultancy Services, o at the same time he's president of a pre-market think tank nga Minimal Government Thinkers Megala, on the need to address sa threat Megala dala sa smuggling o mga kontrabando ilibin na sigarilyo for the millions and perhaps billions of pesos Megala of losses sa revenue sa gobyerno, which will augur well unta mato unta sa services pero tuas kaman sa mga kawatan Megala. Salamat kay Sir Bien.